So, Happy New Year, everyone. Prilav Chigga here, wishing you all the very best for 2020. I wanted to do a vlog just before this year, 2019, ends. It's been a fabulous year. I got a job, a part-time job. I went and travelled, went to Israel, Georgia, and then Thailand, and that was marvellous. And I am going into 2020 thinking that I'm going to resurrect the blog that I was doing, My Pre-Loved Life. For those of you who've been following me, you'll know that it will be 3 years in February. My husband died, and I've lived a solo life, for the last 3 years. And I wanted to write more stories about how that's been for me. Because it's New Year's Eve. It's New Year's Eve now, and I'm going out on my own tonight up to the local pub. Several of my friends decided they were going to have a New Year in, so that's where I'm heading off to. And that's an adventure in itself, for a woman to go to a pub New Year's Eve on her own. Goodness knows what it's going to be like, but I'm off there this evening in about an hour's time. I just want to get this video uploaded. But what have I been doing today? Well, as part of this solo life, I have gone for a walk. I went for a beautiful walk down at the Orwell River on my own, and the sun was setting over the river, and it was absolutely gorgeous. And that was heartening. And I don't very often walk on my own. But I want to do more of that in 2020. And continuing on with the journaling theme, I don't know if I've mentioned this for a while, but this is journal number 18, I want to say. For 3 years, I have been journaling. I can't stop journaling. But the information I put in my journals, I'm going to put into my blog posts because it might help other people going through something similar. Perhaps you haven't had a bereavement, but perhaps you're on your own. And it's a different way of being. And I have been thinking, oh, I must find someone to share my life with. But now I'm thinking, hey, do you know what? Be okay with yourself. I've got lots of great friends. So that's going to be the theme of this blog. So, what else have I been doing? What else can I share with you as we kind of slip out of 2019? Well, I bought this. I haven't had a diary forever and ever. Well, I'm not going to use it as a diary. What I'm going to do with this, oh, and that's one of my pieces of art I put in there, stuck in there today. I'm going to, every day, every evening, I'm going to put this by the side of my bed. And there's lots of things to fill out. New discoveries for 2020. I want to learn. I want to surprise myself by. I am looking forward to. So I might fill those gaps in tomorrow. But the thing that I want to share with you is there's a tiny little bit of space for every day of 2020. And my plan is to write a sentence or two before I go to bed each evening, just being grateful for the day, just being grateful. I'm so grateful for everything that's happened in 2019. There have been some ups and downs, of course, there's going to be, but to keep a gratitude journal is definitely something I'm going to do. And this afternoon, after my walk, I did this. I made all these cards. I kid you not, I was in a production line. I've done it in stages, but I glued them all in today. So all of these brush-o art works, if you like, it's so easy to do. I've added a little bit of gold. At the bottom there, I've put a little stamp, which is my Japanese Elaine stamp with my name on it. And I'll be writing on the back, probably handmade with love, Prilav Chigga. So what do you think of these? I've got so many of them. I've got about 20 of them. A real production line, but I thoroughly enjoyed it. It was like meditative. I just sat here, listened to Sam Harris podcast and just finished these off. It was just such a beautiful thing to do. And These are going to be New Year cards for special people in my life. So if you do get one of these cards, you know that you're a special person to me. So what I'd love you to do, really, I'd love you to do this, is kind of share my YouTube video with anyone you think could benefit from something that's a little bit uplifting. That's my intention. I want to talk about things that are going to help me to have a fulfilled 2020 and maybe inspire a few people along the way. Let's see. Guess what? The video stopped working halfway through, so I've lost all of that, but never mind. I'm just going to leave it by saying wish you all the very best for 2020. And I'm going to say I hope your year is fabulous, and I hope all your traffic lights are green, and I hope you have the wind in your sails wherever you go, whatever you do. But I'd love to hear from you. Do comment, do share, and do get in touch. Let's make it a connected world for 2020. So, got my hat, got the beret, got the coat on, got the handbag. I really do need to go now. It's just a couple of hours before midnight. So all the very best. Till next time.